Hi everyone, my name is Ankit Awasthi. My presentation topic is development and optimization of nanostructural lipid carriers loaded with quercetin. In my presentation, I am going to cover these points. First of all, aim, objectives, preparation of analysis by using homologation followed by propionication, then Zanov experiment using CCD, then optimization of analysis by using CCD, then results and discussion, and finally conclusion. So, first of all, aim. So, my aim of the study was to formulate quercetin nanoparticles by using hot homogenization followed by propionation method. And in this, I am also going to evaluate the effect of processing method and stabilizer suitability on nanostructural lipid carrier preparation and stability by using central composite design. So, next point is objectives. So my objective is to optimization of lipid to drug ratio and surfactant to drug ratio that could give by nanostructured lipid carriers with ideal characteristics to optimize processing factors that could affect the manufacturing process on large scale development. Now preparation of analysis. So in my screen here you are seeing five steps are there. In first step, what we are going to do, we are taking this aqueous phase in a beaker on this magnetic sphere, then we are adding surfactant in that one. In the second step, we are taking co-surfactant and lipids, and we are heating that lipid and co-surfactant above their melting points, and then we are adding the drug in that one. And in the third step, we are going to add lipid phase in the aqueous phase slowly. In the fourth step, we are doing formulation of the emulsion that is prepared in the third step, and then in fifth step, we are doing propionation for homogeneous mixing. Now design of experiment. So on the basis of initial screening, CCD design was applied. In this, solid to liquid lipid ratio and surfactant to co-surfactant ratio were identified as critical factors for CCD. So these factors are performed at two levels. You can see that there are two levels, plus one and minus one. Plus one is the high limit and minus one is a low limit. So in this we are taking three responses. First one is particle size, second is eta potential, and third one is entrapment efficiency. Now these are the optimization analysis using CCD. So on the basis of central composite designs, we got 13 runs. And in the 13 runs, you can see that first factor is ratio of lipids to drug, second factor is ratio of surfactant to drug, and third is then responses, that is particle size, eta potential, and entrapment efficiency. Now from the CCD design, we got polynomial equations. We got three equations. First one is for particle size, then for eta potential, and then for entrapment efficiency. In the particle size, you can see that our equation is plus 90.94 minus 5.49 into A minus 8.64 into B minus 0.7500 into AB plus 9.06 into A square plus 11.76 into B square. So what is the inference of this equation? Here negative sign is the B factor, means whenever there is increase in co-surfactant ratio, means between 80 to transcritical particle size is decreasing. You can see that in zeta potential, positive sign with the B, which indicates that factor B has agonistic effect on the zeta potential. And in entrapment efficiency, you can see that negative sign with the factor A, means whenever there is increase in GMS to capmol ratio, entrapment efficiency of quercetin is decreasing. Here factor A is solid lipid to liquid lipid, and factor B is surfactant to co-surfactant ratio. Then these are the perturbation plots. First, for the zeta potential, you can see that there are two factors, factor A and B. Both are showing no effect on this zeta potential of this quercetin. Both A and B have equal effect on the zeta potential of this quercetin. Now you can see that in perturbation plot of this particle size, this B is more curved than A, means factor B is more dominant than factor A, means whenever there is increase in this surfactant to co-surfactant ratio, particle size is decreasing. Now you can see that perturbation plot of entrapment efficiency, you can see that both factor A and B are showing equal effect on the entrapment efficiency of quercetin. Now these are the counter plots and 3D space response. So what these responses are saying? Whenever there is increase in this surfactant to co-surfactant ratio, this zeta potential is decreasing. And whenever there is this factor A GMS to capmol ratio is increasing, this zeta potential is increasing. Now this is the this perturbation plot for this particle size. You can see that whenever there is increase in GMS to cap mole ratio, there is increase in particle size. But you can say that whenever we are going to the upside, means this region, you can see that whenever there is increase in affinity to transcutol, this particle size is decreasing. Now this is the perturbation plot for entrapment efficiency of quercetin. You can see that whenever there is increase in this 282 transcutol, your entrapment efficiency is increasing. Now this is the graphical optimization of quercetin analysis. On the basis of CCT, we got some values, means particle size low limit is 72 and high limit is 133, and for zeta potential your low limit is minus 16 and high limit is minus 22, and for this entrapment efficiency your high limit is 92 and low limit is 84.32, and we got two values, means x1 is GMS to cap mole, that is 900 microliter, and for this x2 is this 282 transcutol, that is 336.571. On the basis of these values we prepared the formulation, and after that we done the inhibitor drug release. What formulation we have prepared, that is coming under the design of experiment. When we did this inhibitor drug release studies, we found that quercetin is showing 90% drug release in 12 hours, but when we made this analysis of this quercetin, we can see that within 12 hours almost all drug is releasing. So this is the conclusion, means the formulation prepared by analysis optimized using CCT design, and all the values are under the center composite designs, and this optimal formulation is very good for sustained release within 12 hours, while quercetin, pure quercetin, showing 19% drug release within 12 hours. Thank you.